Explosions continue in the Libyan capital of Tripoli now, and our correspondent Steve Harrigan is there. Steve, what's up?
Shepard, within about the past 10 minutes, just as we were talking to you a short time ago, we heard two loud explosions off to my right. It sounded like incoming either cruise missile strikes or attacks from jets. The most recent strikes have been from jets. That's because all of Gaddafi's anti-aircraft systems, the stationary ones, have already been taken out, making it safe for the coalition jets to fly in low. The attacks came from the direction of the compound about 1 mile off to my right. We can't be sure what the target is. Gaddafi himself was seen at that compound just Tuesday night. Pentagon officials insist Gaddafi himself is not a target, but this is the sixth night in a row here after darkness falls. We're seeing strikes, and now, Shepard, we're seeing anti-aircraft fire again as we speak. Off to my right, I'm seeing red streams of bullets up into the air. Now, these are from mobile anti-aircraft positions, often operated manually without radar, so the odds of hitting a coalition fighter jet extremely long with this kind of manual operation. They're basically big guns mounted on the back of pickup trucks, so the odds of hitting a jet very high, very low, and those jets really feel free to control the skies. There's been talk about the no-fly zone in effect. It does run now boundary to boundary all across Libya, and there's been only one test of that no-fly zone so far, and it was earlier today that a Libyan military plane was taken out by a French fighter jet. So coalition forces do control the sky. They are using their air power once again here tonight in Tripoli, using that air power, and again facing some minor resistance from the ground from those mobile anti-aircraft sites. And as we speak, we're seeing some of that red tracer fire go up into the sky once again. We're not sure about the target or the nature of the strike, but for the sixth night in a row, loud crashes, explosions here in the Libyan capital. Shepard, back to you.
And as you were speaking, Steve, Libyan television mentioned the same, and Libyan TV is reporting, and I quote, airstrikes have hit residential and military areas in Tripoli and Tajura. That's not too far away, right?
That's right. Tajura is that working class suburb just east of the capital, and that's where some of the anti-Gaddafi sentiment has stemmed from. The last protests we saw just over 2 weeks ago that were shut down by a heavy security apparatus here came out of Tajura. It's not sure what military installations are in that target, but we're going to have to keep in mind, too, these are strikes in a major city, a populated city of 1.5 million people. It's still very active. People have not fled this city despite the fighting that's going on. As a matter of fact, people haven't even really changed their way of life in this city as of yet. Commerce is still going on, cars still going, all the while we're seeing anti-aircraft fire up into the sky. The big debate we're likely to see as these battles intensify in the cities is over civilian casualties, and it's going to be really tough to verify claims made by state television here versus by coalition officials about state casualties. We're already seeing initial reports from the Libyan government, initial claims of 48, now today another 18. So far, it's been impossible to confirm these claims, and the bodies shown so far have been young military-age males. We're not seeing any women and children offered by the Libyan government as civilian casualties. But the claims are there, and it's likely, as we see more of this battle in urban environments, those claims will continue to grow, Shepard.
Steve Harrigan live for us, Tripoli in Libya, and we'll get back to him as breaking news continues. Steve, thanks very much.